Cells are great travelers. They travel our body all the time. Not for leisure, but work-related. Their travels are necessary for the formation of tissues and to repair damage. But how do they know when to start moving and where to travel to? The Rick Korswagen Group dives into the travel agency of our body and the molecules that guide and schedule our cells' travel plans.
Well, cell migration is an important process, for example, during embryonic development, when cells are formed at a certain place in the embryo, but maybe need to go somewhere else to take part in the formation of tissues or a complete organ. So these cells need to migrate to that specific site, and they're guided to that site with the help of messenger proteins. And we study one particular family, which is called the Wnt family. So the reason why we study it is that it is very important during development, but it's also important later in life. For example, in cancer, where it's now becoming clear that activation of this whole Wnt-dependent process in cancer cells makes the cells move out of the primary tumor, and that is very bad news for cancer patients. T. elegans is really an ideal system to address this kind of question because on the one hand it is very simple, it consists of only 959 cells, and on the other hand it has all the different cell types that we consist of as well, so neurons, muscle cells, intestine, and so on. And we can look at a single cell and see how it migrates, moves, travels in response to this Wnt protein and what the molecular mechanism that is involved in this. We can study that in detail.
So when making time-lapse movies of cell migration in the worms, we encountered several technical hurdles that need to be overcome. So the main thing is that we need to immobilize these worms, so they need to lie still in order for us to image them under a microscope. So we now have a way to immobilize these worms using small plastic beads, microscopic beads, that physically restrict the movement of these worms. And this allows us to perform time-lapse imaging during prolonged periods of time.
So what we find is that the way Wnt makes these cells migrate in C. elegans is actually very similar to how Wnt stimulates cell migration in human cancer cells. And by studying this process in C. elegans, where we can do such detailed studies, we hope that we will learn much more about how this process also works in human cancer cells. And what we expect is that in the future, this knowledge can be used to devise specific therapies for the treatment of cancer cell spreading in human patients.